Welcome back to another episode of What's Going On Today with me, World's Okayest Mechanic. Honestly, I wasn't really sure what I was going to do for today. And I sat here and I kind of thought about it some more. I was like, well, I could do a wiring, like a wiring tuck kind of deal for my backup lights. And I started on that and I broke one of them. So, I was like, well, that sucks. Excuse me. And then, my roommate walks up to me, and he says, Merry Christmas. And he hands me these. There is two of them. I kind of played with them. They're nice. They're not bad. I looked them up. They came from Walmart. But tonight, or today, I guess, I'm going to replace those with those. So maybe people will actually be able to know that I'm in reverse, because flatbed has no reverse lights. So we'll get to putting everything together here in just a second. Let's go to off. I said off. Bust it loose. And then we'll put the power to it. Alright. Now hopefully, I'm hoping that the bulb can come in the package with it. We'll actually fit through there, so I don't have to drill it out any bigger, because that just doesn't seem like fun right now. That one. And they will. Yeah. So, put that there. And throw that on there. That down. I don't know if you're actually supposed to use these nuts on here or not, but I am, because, well, I can always go get more lock nuts. All right, that was not supposed to turn. All right, so I guess I'm gonna have to hold that. Going anywhere. And now it's time. Now, let's see here. Let's unplug that from the harness. And then that'll slide right in there. Hey, those actually sit back a little farther, so maybe I can. Yeah. Maybe that way, if I have to put something up against the bed, I don't have to move these as far. But I'm also putting them up here because if you watched the last video, they are going to double as work lights.
Oh man, I forgot my wrenches.
Oh well, it'll be all right. I can always tighten them up later. All right, and that actually. I think I'm actually going to run these up here,
up along the headache rack.
But I'm going to go ahead and throw the other light on right quick.
And I'll see you in a minute.
All right, I do believe I have figured out how I'm going to do this. And since I already had wires ran for two separate lights, and this is all one circuit, I think I'm going to try this. If it don't work, I'll fix it later. Because it's kind of cold out right now, and I've already lost feeling in my fingers. Let's get that broken wire off of there. Come on. There we go.
Alright. And then we'll peel that one over.
I'm just going to kind of fan these out. And then all three wires are gonna hook right together. So let's speed this up for you real quick.
I do want to apologize for wrapping this video up and not carrying you guys along. I just reused the wiring from my old lights, and apparently that was a bad idea because they were always on. Couldn't turn them off. My switch didn't work, and it actually started melting some of the wires, so I kind of had to rush a fix for it, and I got carried away and finished everything. But here is the finished product. Have a light. I ran the wire through here just for now until I can tie it up. Same thing with right here. I just kind of bundled everything together and then wrapped it back up in the little red tie thing. This light, I just ran it through here so it's out of the way, so my back glass is still mostly clear. And I mean, you saw earlier, they work. They still work. Now they work on a switch. So, till next time, catch you later.